The best surgery until now, and it's the most ideal surgery, but it is expensive. It is an absolutely sutureless surgery. Why do I call it sutureless? Because the size of the incision is so very small, and also the incision is multiplanar. Let's describe the incision. It is less than 3 millimeters. It is less than 3 millimeters in size, and it is a valvular incision, something like this. See, it goes in three different planes. So it creates a valve-like action. So a valve is self-sealing. You don't have to apply sutures. First of all, because it's so small, also because of its design. That's a valvular structure. That the incision is a valvular incision. And also the incision, you can term it as a tunnel, because it has a roof, floor and walls. So it's typically called a scleral corneal tunnel incision. Okay. Now after you make this incision, it is so small, you pass a metallic tip into the incision, and with an ultrasonic frequency of 40,000 cycles per minute, the tip of this metallic instrument breaks the lens so that you can emulsify and suck it out of the eye. Okay, that is the mechanism with ultrasonic frequency. Now, how do you place an IOL through such a small incision? Here is the important discovery of a foldable IOL. It is made out of silicone, or it is an acrylic IOL. You fold it, an IOL as large as 6 millimeters, you can fold it and pass it through an incision of 3 millimeters. See, this is how a foldable IOL is folded into half and passed into the small incision of phacoemulsification. However, it is less time consuming, and an important feature is that 6-6 vision is restored, compared to 6-18 vision in ECCE and finger counting in ICCE. 6-6 vision, that is absolutely normal vision, is restored in this. Okay. Now the steps, we make a 3 mm incision and an anterior capsulotomy is done with a continuous curvilinear capsular excess. This is the typical word which we use for the capsulotomy done in phacoemulsification, continuous curvilinear capsular excess. Okay. See, this is how you start the capsulorhexis, and you keep on proceeding the rhexis entirely, and finally you have a beautiful opening over here. That is your CCC. After that, here are two important terms you need to remember without getting confused. Hydrodissection is to separate cortex from the capsule by injecting water between the two layers. Cortex from capsule is hydrodissection. Now, hydrodelineation is separation of nucleus into epi and endonucleus. See, an easy way to remember in the exam, the delineation has two N's, right? So it's something to do with the nucleus, which also starts with NN. Okay, it is separation of nucleus into epinucleus and endonucleus. After that, you do the phacoemulsification with your metallic tip and an ultrasonic frequency of 40,000 cycles per second, and then you insert a foldable IOL, right? Now let's look at its brother, the small incision cataract surgery. This is important because phacoemulsification is an expensive procedure, and not everybody can afford the instrument that is required for phacoemulsification. So SICS is similar to this. Let's compare these two. It's a 3 mm incision in phaco, whereas SICS has a 6 mm incision, a little bit larger. A machine is used in phaco, but the advantage of SICS is that it is a manual technique. Foldable IOL is used in phaco, whereas a PMMA IOL is used in SICS. Both are sutureless. However, please note, SICS is also sutureless. Both restore 6x6 normal vision. And our striking difference, that phaco is expensive, whereas SICS is economical. Okay. Now let's look at the phaco handle. It's made up of a titanium tip of 0.9 mm diameter. This tip breaks the lens into small pieces with the ultrasonic frequency that we have seen. A silicone infusion sleeve, which you can see here, it has a diameter of 1.9 millimeters and it allows the fluid to pass into the eye. Now, what is the use of this fluid? It has two important uses. It keeps the tip cool. Because of this high frequency, you can understand there's heat generated that damages the eye. So, this silicone infusion allows fluid that keeps on cooling the titanium tip, and it also prevents the anterior chamber from collapsing. Okay, so you can understand how the 3 mm incision is made in phaco. 0.9 mm for the titanium tip and 1.9 mm from the infusion sleeve, a total of 3 mm. So, with phaco tip, an incision of less than 3 mm is not possible. So, we have devised a newer technique where you use a incision measurement of 0.9 mm only. Okay, it is called MICS or bimanual phaco or phaconit. Let's see what this is. What MICS is. It's micro incision cataract surgery, also known as bimanual phaco or phaconit. So what we do is we remove the silicone tip over here. So we are left with only the phaco tip that is of 0.9 millimeter diameter that is held in one hand. And to replace the fluid giving silicone tip, we use a side port that substitutes one of the functions of the sleeve of the phaco tip. And an assistant keeps on putting a cold balanced salt solution to maintain the temperature to reduce the heat. Okay, see, an irrigating chopper is held in the other hand and one hand has 0.9 mm. So, 0.9 mm phaco tip. So, the actions of the phaco sleeve are replaced by a side port and an assistant pouring cold BSS continuously. Okay, that is why, because we are using two ports, it is called a bimanual phaco. Okay, now after the lens is emulsified, an ultra thin rollable, see our incision is only 0.9 millimeter, right? So we need an ultra thin rollable intraocular lens. However, before you place, you just enlarge it to about 1.2 millimeter. Okay, just a little bit you enlarge and you insert the rollable IOL, something like this. Okay, that, see, the IOL is rolled and it is being pushed into the posterior capsule where it is placed. Now, another latest technique is your femtosecond laser. This is the most advanced cataract surgery where a laser beam is used for phaco emulsification and not a phaco tip. So, another use of laser is that a perfect incision is made with the laser beam itself. Now, look at this incision picture over here, and this also, it's so perfect. It's like you have drawn it with a scale and a compass, you know. It's so beautiful, the incision that is made with the femtosecond laser. So, the capsulorhexis is also perfect. The incision is also perfect. And then, another advantage of that is very less energy is delivered. So, there is less trauma to the eye. The laser delivers very much less energy compared to the 40,000 cycles per second used by phaco. So, that is another advantage of femtosecond laser. However, the only drawback is you can understand that it is highly expensive procedure. That's the drawback of femtosecond laser.
Hello everyone. This is Dr. Sai Suguna, your mentor for ophthalmology at MedicoApp. Now, thanks for watching the video. Now, we have put such videos all together in our ophthalmology app. The trial version you can download from the link over here or in the description box below.